You gotta be on your ass.
Today, we're gonna dive deep into the twisted world of The Sopranos to uncover the top three most sick bastards that had us all simultaneously fascinated and repulsed. Get ready as we uncover the ultimate contenders for the title of the most sick bastard on The Sopranos.
What do we have here? What is this, a handsome contest?
First up, let's talk about Ralphie Cifaretto. This man had a special blend of psychopathy and self-absorption that truly sets the bar for being a sick bastard. Now, Ralphie did have his redemption arc.
I know it's tough on you. I'm the guy that's dating your mom.
Dating?
Don't get fucking filthy about it.
You want to question a New Jersey business practice that goes back 70 years?
A little bit, but he mostly had a knack for being a pain in the ass. Whether he was beating the daylights out of poor Tracy, who was just a stripper, who could never catch a break. And, you know, she was a pregnant woman who was carrying his unborn child. This man had a PhD in brutality. Let's not forget those cheese grates.
All right, kiddies, that's enough for tonight.
Next in line is Richie Aprile, the living, breathing example of a sick bastard. Of course, Richie had anger issues.
So what the fuck, Rich? Mattress at the shelter a little too lumpy? There are men in the camp better looking at my sister.
But remember, he thought it was perfectly reasonable to run over Beansy twice.
Richard, no, Richie, no!
If you need help, I'll fucking help you. You understand? You talk to me.
That's some next level sick bastard thinking, my friends. And let's not forget his relationship with Janice. Let's not forget this. As you can see, Richie wasn't one to play by the rules. He had his own code of honor. If he didn't like somebody, he had no qualms about erasing them from existence. But this guy's disregard for respect and loyalty made the mafia look like a free-for-all. That's why he couldn't sell it.
Put my fucking dinner on the table and keep your mouth shut.
We buried him. On a hill. Overlooking a little river. With pine cones all around.
You did?
Lastly, we can't forget the granddaddy of them all, Tony Soprano himself. He is the master of manipulation and a bona fide sick bastard.
You know what? Fuck this! You got a lot of fucking balls, you know that?
Tony had a way of turning violence into an art form. We all loved it. Suffocating Christopher, ordering hits left and right, you name it. He had a penchant for inflicting pain and enjoying it.
No. Come here. In that spec house, I made the down payment. I bought the materials. I leaned on that building inspector when you had your thumb up your ass for 20 fucking years and fiddled with the air conditioning and fucking bitch and complain and fucking bitch to me, to your priest.
It just went beyond standard mobster job description. He loved it. But Tony's twistedness didn't stop at physical violence. No. He took it a step further with his own brand of emotional manipulation.
That's enough of you and your stupid fucking remarks. Go back to Miami and play volleyball, whatever the fuck it is you do down there.
The way he plays mind games with people, his family, his friends. In his mind, it's a soap opera, and he's running the whole show.
You preach all this wise guy shit, and meanwhile, the only ones who gotta play by the rules are us.
Now it's time to decide who is the most sick bastard, and upon reflection, and with help of a board of Sopranos connoisseurs, we have all decided that the most sick bastard on The Sopranos is Tony Soprano.
So he says I planned it all along. That I could see 20 steps down the road how it was going to go and how he was going to get screwed. According to him, it's subconscious, second nature.